Former British spy Christopher Steele admitted that he relied on an unverified report on a CNN website for part of the Trump dossier, which was used as a basis for the FBI's investigation into Trump. According to deposition transcripts released this week, Steele said last year he used a 2009 report he found on CNN's iReport website and said he wasn't aware that submissions to that site are posted by members of the public and are not checked for accuracy. A web-archive from July 29, 2009 shows that CNN described the site in this manner: iReport.com is a user-generated site. That means the stories submitted by users are not edited, fact-checked or screened before they post. In the dossier, Steele, a Cambridge-educated former MI6 officer, wrote about extensive allegations against Donald Trump, associates of his campaign, various Russians and other foreign nationals, and a variety of companies including one called Webzilla. Those allegations would become part of an FBI investigation and would be used to apply for warrants under the Foreign Intelligence Surveillance Act. During his deposition, Steele was pressed on the methods he used to verify allegations made about Webzilla, which was thought to be used by Russia to hack into Democratic emails. When asked if he discovered anything of relevance concerning Webzilla during the verification process, Steele replied, "We did. It was an article I have got here which was posted on July 28, 2009 on something called CNN iReport. I do not have any particular knowledge of that," Steele said when asked what was his understanding of how the iReport website worked. When asked if he understood that content on the site was not generated by CNN reporters, he said, "I do not." He was then asked, "Do you understand that they have no connection to any CNN reporters?" Steele replied, "I do not." He was pressed on this further, "Do you understand that CNN iReports are aware nothing more than any random individual's assertions on the internet?" Steele replied, "No, I obviously presume that if it is on a CNN site that it may have some kind of CNN status. I write that it may be an independent person posting on the site." When asked about his methodology for searching for this information, Steele described it as what we could call an open source search, which he defined as where you go into the internet and you access material that is available on the internet that is of relevance or reference to the issue at hand or the person under consideration. Steele said his dossier contained RAV intelligence that he admitted could contain untrue or even deliberately false information. Steele was hired by the opposition research firm Fusion GPS to investigate den Kandidaten Donald Trump in 2016. Fusion GPS was receiving funding at the time from the Clinton campaign and the DNC through the Perkins Coie law firm. The series of memos that Steele would eventually compile became known as the Trump dossier. The dossier was used in FISA applications to survey Trump campaign associate Carter Page. When asked whether he warned Fusion GPS that the information in the dossier might be Russian disinformation, Steele admitted that a general understanding existed between US and Fusion that a material contained this risk. Steele also described his interactions with then John McCain's aide David Kramer, whose own deposition showed that he provided BuzzFeed with a copy of the dossier and had spoken with more than a dozen journalists about it. "I provided copies of the December memo to Fusion GPS for onward passage to David Kramer at the request of then John McCain," Steele said. Then McCain nominated him as the intermediary. "I did not choose him as the intermediary. When asked if he told Kramer that he couldn't vouch for everything that was produced in the memos, Steele replied, yes, with an emphasis on everything. When asked why he believed it was so important to provide the dossier to them, McCain, Steele said, because I judged it had national security implications for the United States and the West as a whole.